Huff a day. I'm Rear Admiral Ben Nicholson, Commander Joint Region Marianas. As we mark the 77th anniversary of Guam's liberation, I ask we take a moment to remember. Remember the 18,000 military members who stormed the beaches of Agat and Asin, fighting for a foothold in the Pacific, fighting for the protections of our Guamanian brothers and sisters, fighting to secure and restore freedom around the world. Remember the Chamorro people who suffered and those who died during the World War II occupation. The liberation of Guam was an extraordinary turning point in our history. This liberation sealed a bond between the people of the island and our U.S. Armed Forces. Today, we're committed to this bond. We are dedicated more than ever to continue to protect and defend Americans and our freedoms from these shores and in this region to maintain a free and open Pacific region. Every Liberation Day, we celebrate the culture and the spirit of the Chamorro people who persevered through adversity and commemorate the efforts of our American liberators. As your regional commander, I thank you for all you do in defense of our great nation. I thank you for all you do in support of those who put themselves in harm's way every day. On behalf of Joint Region Marianas, we are honored and humbled to be able to once again celebrate with you. God bless Guam, our great people, and our great nation. Biba Liberation, Biba Guam.
Buenas an half a day. Team Anderson would like to wish you a joyous 77th Liberation Day anniversary. Last year saw the cancellation of many events honoring the anniversary. This Liberation Day, we're proud to stand with you once again in celebration and recognition of the bravery of the Chamorro people and the heroes that fought to liberate and defend the freedoms we hold dear.
Today not only memorializes the battle that took place in 1944, but also reminds us the reason we serve, to protect the people and the freedoms that make America great.
We'd like to thank the people of Guam for the continued support you have shown Team Anderson throughout the years. Your support is the driving force that allows us to project air power throughout the Indo-Pacific.
It is an honor to call Guam our home, to experience the rich culture of the Chamorro people, and to enjoy the natural beauty of the island.
While we celebrate Guam's liberation, we must also celebrate the partnerships and the friendships that have been cultivated over the past 77 years. We were there for you in 1944, and we will continue to be here for you now and in the future. Andankalu, Nasija Usmaase, Biba Guam.
Half a day. I am Lieutenant Colonel Tate Bunce, the Acting Commanding Officer for Marine Corps Base Camp Laws. This year, we celebrate the 77th anniversary of the liberation of Guam a little bit differently. After enduring a global pandemic, we, the Marines, celebrate the liberation of Guam with you. Today, we gather in solemn remembrance to pay respect and to show our gratitude to the brave men and women who fought to liberate this beautiful island, our home, 77 years ago. Together, we pay tribute to those who made the ultimate sacrifice and celebrate those who rebuilt Guam after the war's destruction threatened to strip the island of its rich cultural traditions. On this 77th anniversary of the liberation, we are inspired by the perseverance of Guam in the face of adversity and the fortitude they exhibited to guarantee the survival of their culture and way of life. During this time of celebration, we also pay homage to the thousands of men and women from all of the U.S. Armed Services who fought for a cause greater than themselves with a devotion to duty and country to free the people of Guam. Let the hardships and suffering endured by both the people of Guam and their liberators serve not just as a reminder of the horrors of war, but as a living memorial to the importance of peace. It is fitting that we remember the courage, commitment, and untold sacrifices made so that we, their descendants, can live in a better world. It is our obligation to honor their legacy and affirm their resolve to uphold the values for which they were prepared to die. Emboldened by their brave example, let us continue to work together to enrich the future of Guam. Sizuus, Maasi, and Semper Fidelis.
Buenas on half a day, Guam. I am Captain Nick Simmons, Commander of Coast Guard Sector Guam, and I wanted to take this moment to celebrate the 77th annual Liberation Day and to recognize the heroes who made the ultimate sacrifice for the freedom of this island and its people on July 21st, 1944. The enormous courage and fortitude demonstrated to liberate Guam were truly heroic and will remain inspirational for generations to come. and the role that the Coast Guard played in those events remains a source of great pride for the service even today. It saddens me there may not be an annual Liberation Day parade for our Coast Guard men and women to march in and for our families to enjoy, resulting from the ongoing pandemic. However, as the island and our nation make continuous steps towards again achieving freedom, this time from the threat of an unseen enemy, I encourage everyone to make time to join with family and friends to commemorate and honor the sacrifices made to liberate Guam. Undenkulu nasi zuus maase.
In many ways, Liberation Day is a reflection of the resilient spirit of the Chamorro people. When typhoons flattened shelters, we fortified homes. When colonizers tried to prevent us from speaking our language, we strengthened our mother tongue. And from the devastation of war, our people rose from the ashes. After 77 years, we continue to honor the sacrifices of our greatest generation and the American soldiers, sailors, and Marines. We commemorate, we celebrate, and we will never forget. Japanese occupation during World War II remains a dark chapter in our history. Our greatest generation endured years of hardship and incomprehensible loss. Every July 21st, we recognize how our people overcame this adversity and rebuilt Guam. Today is a reminder of our resilience as a people. As long as Chamorros have existed, we persevered, we endured, men met good hit. I am proud of our people. This is another year. We cannot traditionally commemorate Liberation Day, but we continue to remember, honor, and respect the sacrifices of our people and the brave service members who continue to protect our freedom. Biba Guahan, then Biba Liberation.
Manotigit, gisan hilo, iman opkot na totlang siha, zaintina iman matau, iman mofa na natautau, niman matug iman finetne na nasakman siha. Intina, iman yanin mami, zaintina iman opkot na totlang siha. Intina, intina iman matau, intina iman matau, intina iman mofot na na tau tau, intina iman mofot na na tau tau, iman matau, iman matau, iman mofot na na tau tau.
KGTF TV proudly presents the Liberation Day Parade.
Buenos dias and a happy Liberation.
And we're here at the Liberation Day Parade.
Welcome back to the 19th Liberation Day Parade.
Well, happy Liberation Day, everyone.
Rudy? Rudy. MTM, Rudy Paco. All day.
In Aloha, see that? I can recite the 50 states in less than 30 seconds. Make you fast.
It's like making a movie.
I am Robert Raymond De La Cruz Hoffman. I am 44 years old. I'm the mayor for Sinahania, and our population is about 2,582. Sinahania has a very unique history in itself because it was a project of the federal government after a typhoon, a super typhoon, came and destroyed the whole village. So in the early days, it was used for farming land, and everything that was grown in Sinahania was taken down to Hagatnya. And then during the war, when Hagatnya was bombed out, many sought shelter here and hid here. The farmland was still around. And then right after that, there was a huge rebuilding effort. And then a super typhoon in the 60s damaged pretty much a lot of Sinahania. So they tore it all down, and Urban Renewal with HUD came and said, we're going to rebuild your community, put sidewalks, everything underground. And so they did it, and it was a very expensive project, I would say, for that time. But it's been kind of that way. And so we've seen a modern type of village setting. You know, we don't have skyscrapers, but we're considered very urban. As we celebrate the 77th year, one of the most moving experiences, I think, was just helping them fill out their war claims efforts and their paperwork here. And that kind of really hit home. It brought war right in front of you, because the stories they explained of things exploding right in front of them, or seeing their own family members killed, you know, you're just amazed that they survived through that. And how they are now, how loving and forgiving, and they're able to just function. I'm like, wow, I'm surprised, you know, you guys are not, I would be a total wreck if certain things happened like this. So they've really risen above. And I feel that they've learned from the experience, and I think they want us to learn. When you read the books, the war survivor books, or you read the personal accounts of people who've put together certain books, you really get a sense of everybody had a unique experience. There's a lot of information that is out there still that I think our people haven't seen yet, which are in museums like the Marine Corps Museum, at the Navy Museum, at the Smithsonian, at the National Archives, where there were war correspondents then taking photos of everything and film, and we've only seen maybe a snippet of it. At that time, things happened, and for that time, there were lessons there's lessons to be learned and taught there. And I think, you know, like I said, we don't want it to be lost to the ages. So we're forever grateful. And as we kind of move forward and kind of figure out what we're gonna celebrate in terms of liberation, it was always mindful that it's not just that party side, that we really put an emphasis on the prayer and the reflection and the memorial side of it. So I think that's, looking back, I think that's, we gotta continue to do that. Happy Liberation, Guam. This is Mayor Robert Hoffman. We love you, we're praying for you, we're gonna remember you. To our survivors and to our military, thank you.
My name is Vicente Salas Taytagui. My title is the mayor of Talofofo, also known as God's Country. Altogether now, I've been mayor for 5 terms. The best place now to visit Talofofo is the Ladi of the Valley. You know, that's where the culture down there, the Ladi Stone. You ride the boat down to the village. That's how the way people are long time ago, to go to the, you know, the ranch, they ride the boat there, down the river, and go to the other side to farm. Then we have the, you know, the Talofofo Cave here. You can go there and get a good view. If you want to play golf, come on down. We got 3 golf courses around my village. If you want to play baseball, come on down to Talofofo, play baseball. We do our best to accommodate all the people's need. Liberation to me is, you know, peace. Peace of mind, love, worshiping God, you know, that's what liberation is. I'm very thankful for all this, for the opportunities we have. It's very important. That's part of our culture. We don't want to forget where we came from and who we are. We are tomorrow's, and we all love each other. And we need to, you know, retain our culture. We need to retain our values. We need to remember what happened to our forefathers. So let's unite together and pray for peace. Right now the world is in trouble. Let's pray for peace and prosperity so we can move forward after this pandemic, so we can prosper and improve our island. I want to take this opportunity to extend to my residents, people of Guam, a big, blessed liberation activities. Although we are under this pandemic situation, we're able to move forward to celebrate this event. It's very important not to forget what happened in the past.
So, Mayor, can you tell us what does Liberation Day mean to you?
Well, Liberation is one of our main festivity of the island, and that's because it's like Thanksgiving for us Chamorros, especially in Guam.
And I heard last year that one guy said it's just one big party. It's a chance for everyone on the island, whether you're a transplant or you've been here all your life, to get a chance to come on down and enjoy Guam.
Yes, that's very true.
Okay, thank you very much, Mayor. Back to you.
I am Mayor Paul McDonald. I am from Agana Heights. We have a population of just over 5,000. The longest and the most festive was the 50th anniversary that I was involved. We used to bring our manamkos to our floats and participate in the float, and most of those manamkos would want to ride the floats and be seen. And it's nice to look at them and just think of how they were, you know, during the war. You know, my mom is 95 years old, is going to be 95 years old, and she loves to participate. But sometimes I just sit and watch my mom talk, you know, to others and other war survivors, and it's very interesting to hear them say, oh, Togay is where I grew up, San Antonio, San Ignacio. You know, these are villages, pre-war villages that they talk about most. They enjoy sharing their experience with others. I'm proud to be from Agana Heights because we're still very much family-oriented. We have worked together to make our Agana Heights Elementary School the number one school for many, many years. Another thing, nobody has come close to our record for our after-school program. We have the most busiest gym and the busiest baseball field. We have the Agana Heights Athletics Organization that have been in existence for almost 30 years. Agana Heights Summer Camp. We are in existence for over 25 years. That's what I'm proud of. You know, we are very consistent. There was never a time that we had not skipped a year until this pandemic. Our organization is stagnant now, but we still meet, you know, to discuss what our plans are and what we hope to do. And it's like we're oiling our organization to move right away when this pandemic is over. On behalf of the Agana Heights residents and our office, we hope that you enjoy the 77th Liberation Day. And we hope to get this pandemic over with and hope to see you in the festivities.
Half a day. My name is Vince Regis, director of Inet Nun Gef Pagu and master of Chamorro dance. We are here at beautiful Plaza de España in beautiful Hagatña. The dance you're about to see is our Spanish influence segment called Culut Sia. Enjoy. On behalf of Inetnun Gefbagu Cultural Arts Program, we'd like to wish our brothers and sisters from Guam and around the world a blessed and beautiful and happy 77th Guam Liberation. Biba Tsamoru, Biba Lingwahi, Biba Kutura, Biba Guahan.
My name is Melissa Savaris. I am the mayor of Dedido, and we have over 45,000 residents in Dedido at this time. We have two senior citizen centers here in Dedido and Estumbo. Also, we have two cultural groups that are in our community to enhance and preserve our Chamorro culture. And in this, we also work with drug-free prevention programs. The seniors who are participants, and we have our COVID seniors who come, they get meals, free hot meals for lunch, delivered or picked up. In Dedido, we don't have a memorial that we celebrate here. However, my neighbors do, and so we partner with our different groups, whether it be nonprofit, other government entities, and of course the families that live here. If we're not participating in a Queen's contest and having fundraisings for that, because that was actually what funds the entire Liberation festivity. Is the money brought in through the raffle ticket sales of the Queen's competition. Many of our sainas here in Dedido had a different war experience that did not entail them marching to concentration camp. Some of them stayed at their lanzus, and I remember several saying, oh, we stayed in the caves that were just at the bottom of the cliff near the beach sides. And, you know, some even said, well, we didn't even remember that the war had ended until we saw I Americanu, the white people, coming in. And so, of course, it was the interaction that they had with that. Many of our Manamkos, their sainas, they talk about what they experienced, but then also they talk about forgiveness. Of course, a pandemic has really changed our world, right, and our lives. And, you know, I reflect, and liberation is really about healing and forgiveness, right? Because we saw the atrocities of what the effects of war was. And we saw that during COVID, people were dying around us. What's important is that, you know, we take this time while we're down. It gave us time to reflect, right? What are we doing wrong? It gave our environment time to heal. During this pandemic and post-pandemic is to celebrate liberation, we need to learn how to heal, and part of the healing is to forgive. I am Mayor Melissa Savaris, and I want to wish all of you a happy 77th Liberation Festivity and Celebration. Be safe and God bless you all.
Okay, we're gonna start the tour pretty soon, guys. Anyone for tour, 5 minutes.
This facility is called Corazón y Sengsang. This is our thrift store, the first of the four buildings. I like to say that the items are previously loved, and so they're able to go back to a new family and be used again. Back in that area is the kitchen and the book room. I kind of like to let people see the kitchen area because on the voucher program, we help the homeless shelter next door with vouchers to get either transitioned into the shelter or to come out into the community and have a home in the community. It's a needs voucher, and it's something that we've done since the thrift store was opened 6 years ago. We like to encourage volunteers by telling them that if you volunteer for 15 hours, you get a $5 store credit, which helps you and helps us and lets you know that how much we appreciate you. The thrift store also serves as a training facility. So if you have a need for work to show that you're volunteering through community service, then we'll offer certificates for that. So this, I like to say, is the real public side of Island Girl Power. And people can, come in, do their shopping. But then again, it's a funnel. It's a funnel to bring people from the community in to take advantage of the rest of the services. And they'll know more about the program when they come in to shop at the thrift store, which is kind of cool because, you know, they'll learn about the thrift, the self-defense classes, if we're having an event in the community, or if there's a special guest speaker and they have children, we'll let them know about the different classes that are coming up. A lot of the plants you see around here are either gonna be medicine plants, or cultural art plants, or food plants. And so some of them are for revenue, like the fortune bamboo, but this is our native gausali, and this is our local plumeria. And so we're promoting the native plants because we want the native birds to come back. We have the times where we bring in the native, the food plants, and teach the girls how to make cultural dishes. And not only teach them how to cook it, but how to also process it. And you know, if it's taro, it takes a little bit to learn how to process it for cooking and teach them different recipes. We also have gardening classes to teach them how to grow. Come on in this way. So this is our family enrichment center. We have a lot of furniture that was donated, but this is a dance and exercise studio. This is also the space that we have self-defense classes when we're back and up and running again. So this is the girls' clubhouse. We do a lot to teach girls coping skills, healthy relationship skills, and also the cooking and nutrition classes. We bring in wonderful guest speakers and instructors to teach everything from bush cutting to regular arts and crafts projects. And when something happens, you know, like the little girls fall down, they scrape their knee, we get some of the local medicine plants and teach them how to use the medicine plants to make their sore better. Or if they have a headache, which plant, you know, is useful for that. And then we also have different plants that we make tea from around the center. So we get our knowledge from the Joamtis, from Surohana, different Surohanas on the island. Although it doesn't look very nice, this is the milkweed, and it's gone through a really aggressive season with caterpillars. And these caterpillars and the chrysalis will turn into the monarch butterfly. So this tree we have on the property to grow butterflies. We are growing butterflies with this tree. So we teach people about gardening and the need for pollinators, the need for bees and butterflies to help us pollinate. This is the community garden. Any family in the community can rent a garden plot. A lot of the times they're connected to the girls in the program, but not necessarily. And then we also save plots for families that are in the homeless shelter or different situations where they're not able to pay the $20 a year. So some plots are sponsored. So a family will come in and they'll garden for their self, for their own family. There's no gardening and selling. This is not a place to to grow a business. We're trying to teach people how to be sustainable for their own families. This place is all about suicide prevention, teen pregnancy, sexual assault and family violence prevention. And we just try to offer a really positive environment for everyone. So what I'm doing is I'm picking the seed pod from a vine that I make sure is growing around the center. And this helps to understand what our purpose is. In nature, sometimes nature gives us hints about what, you know, what we're here for. On each seed is a perfect white heart. We're here to love. We're here to love each other. We're here to love ourselves. And we're here to spread that love and pass that love on to everyone in the community. And so when people come to the center here, we want to share that positivity and that love with everyone and let them know that no matter if they're coming for community service or they're teenagers just trying to figure their way and, you know, giving them that purpose for life every single day. And this is, our center is called Corazón es Sengsong, the heart of the village. And that's what we do here. On behalf of Corazón es Sengsong Island Girl Power, I would like to wish all Guamanians everywhere happy 77th Liberation.
My name is Raven Atividad. To me, what liberation means is doing the things you want without having any sort of restrictions. Like, for example, you can choose your own type of religion, you can wear what you want, you can talk how you want, talk whatever your own native language. That specific type of drill is called armed exhibition drill. Exhibition would stand for, like, having no sort of rules and just doing any type of freestyles. And regulation drill is more of like the steady, more robotic type of looking thing where you're just moving it in certain movements. When I first started doing this whole exhibition thing, I would think that thing was like the heaviest thing on earth. If you were taught correctly and the more you practice, eventually it will just become like a toy. It just feels like something you could use all day. In middle school, I've always been a military person. And my dad was like, oh, you should join ROTC. I'm like, oh, what is ROTC? Then come freshman year, I joined ROTC, and then all I wanted to do was just look cool in uniform. But now I'm here as a senior, I realize that ROTC isn't just being looking cool. It actually helps you become a more better person in general, and you become more disciplined.
Is there anything that you'd like to say to family?
Maybe just one thing. Hi, Mom and Dad, I'm on TV.
That's it?
Yep, that's it.
I'd say I'm a pretty fun person. I like to do things that no one else would, so if you would dare me to do something, I would do it. Right. So I did the unarmed. Unarmed is just like armed, but without the rifle. It has all the same movements, but you can basically perfect it if you're an unarmed. Since middle school, I've always wanted to join the military. It's always been a dream of mine. A step forward to that dream is to join Junior ROTC. Since I've joined, I've gained confidence, loyalty, dependability. I've learned how to work well with others and work well with myself, and learning a lot from my instructors, my mentors, and peers. Commanding. It's different for everyone. When I give a command, they have the discipline to execute it. And for me, it took, I'd say, a month or two, because I had my mentor help me throughout those months. It's very hard if you're not like used to it, but over time, if you have good people helping you, it's pretty easy. Liberation, actually every year, my uncle, he works at Fokai Shop. So we always set up there, have like a food party and, you know, I'm always the one balut tanning, you know, like keeping all the food to myself. It's honestly a very great experience seeing the parade. Hi, Mom. Thanks for supporting me and Grandma. Alex, he's my mentor. Caitlin's my mentor. Shout out to you guys for helping me come a long way.
Dress, right? Dress!
I didn't join until my sophomore year because during my freshman year, I wasn't put into the program. The interest that really drove me that I obtained during my freshman year was seeing some of my friends that were in the program and seeing them in their uniform, neat uniform, and knowing how to salute and just being an overall great student from the eye. For me, I really appreciate that. I had very much respect for them and I wanted that as well. Sophomore year, I really was planning to be determined, and I wanted to be that determined student I'd see in them. This was honestly the first time I've ever done an arm drill. Seeing it firstly, before learning all the different hands and coordination, I thought it would be very easy and it would just be, you know, clapping, doing slapping, all that. But really, it's about having very strict forming. You have to make sure your hands are straight. And you make the cupping sound so it's loud and clear. And being very strict with every movement you make. In the end, it's just your body that you're using and nothing else. Me and my family go every year to the parade and have our fiestas. I know it's a day we celebrate to remember those. Remember the soldiers that fought for the U.S. military and then also our local heroes. I'm still looking forward to it, no matter what we do during that day. I hope we get to eat plentiful still during the celebration.
Go, are we?
Just yeah, have a good day to celebrate.
I was part of the honor guard, so we were doing sword manual. It's very technical.
Stop! Fall in!
We always have a preparatory command before we execute anything. There's a preparatory command, and then there's a execution.
It just required us to like work together and try to synchronize our step, like step by step, here and there.
Carry, sword, present.
All that time that you've been practicing, it feels great to pull it off.
Sword, parade.
Prior to the pandemic, around 2 or 3 years ago, I did go with like my family and my aunt to witness the parade. Everybody walking down, you know, just the street, everybody there. Just the vibe was pretty good.
March!
It's like a day to commemorate, you know, for the fallen and who fought for the freedom of our island.
Stop!
Well, liberation means to have the ability to live a life without any boundaries stopping you from, well, whatever you want to be in life.
Start!
Thank you, Mom, for always dropping me to school and for being there when times have been rough. And for my dad, too, because he's very hardworking. He shows me how to do many things in life.
I just want to tell my family thanks for supporting me all the time and always, and like letting me volunteer for all these events that has been happening. Thank you for supporting me, and love you all.
Abigail, come here to ROTC.
On behalf of Guam's Ukuru High School, Murray Carr Jr., ROTC.
Happy 77 Liberation, Guam! Hoorah!
Welcome to Ivan and to our friends from Japan. Thank you for the decades and decades of your participation. I understand the vision of this organization. Not only does it provide a facility for people to enjoy a lot of these hobbies and actually these lifelong sports and devotions, it's going to continue to place Guam on the map and encourage a lot of people to come in.
Always an honor for the APL family to be participating with this event. It really draws the community together. It seems like every year it's getting better. New drivers, new trucks. Whatever we can do to make this better every year, just count on us. Thank you once again.
Our sponsors here. The other guy I'd really like to thank is our Lieutenant Governor. He helped us get things started. I want you guys to really thank our Lieutenant Governor for that.
I fell in love with Guam, and not only with Guam, but the people, the food, the culture, the area, everything about it, and especially the racetrack and the Smoking Wheels race.
My name is Anthony Sanchez. I am the mayor of Jigo. We have a population of about 22,000 people. We have the Japanese Memorial Park, which is one of the first actual monuments that was ever built on this island. It's on Middleac Street. And then we also have the Chagian Memorial. What liberation means to me, it means the sacrifices that our manomkus paid. You know, I've lost my grandparents, so you just thinking of them during the liberation days, you know, it really just brings back a lot of memories growing up with them. Memories were going down and watching the parade when it was really, really an actual village float, getting up early morning just to travel down to Marine Drive to set up ourselves for the parade route and all. And we're sitting out there for like hours. After this pandemic, hopefully we can get our mononcles together and celebrate it the way I think it should be celebrated, with them being that they came from this time. So right now, this is the time we should be honoring them. I mean, we see people going out there and just holding back on what they really want to do because of what we are going through right now. And I'm just hoping that we pull out of this, you know, bring our village back together the way it's supposed to be and have fun. My future dreams for the village is trying to get more community involvement in the village, trying to get more community involvement into a neighborhood watch program, which we're just trying to start. So, you know, hopefully the people can come out and help support it. My name is Anthony Sanchez. I am the mayor of Jigo. To my constituents of Jigo, happy liberation. I know this is the time of year that we should be celebrating liberation, but, you know, this is the time we have to be safe. So hopefully by next year, we have more things to celebrate coming out of this pandemic. It'll be our liberation.
My name is Bill Ginkinga. I'm the proud mayor of the village of Zonia. And there's about 6,000 plus residents that live here. Yeah, Zonia actually is a beautiful village to visit. Tagatang is one of the good main spots where a lot of tourists go to swim, enjoy the beach, take pictures, watch the sunrise. We also have a memorial park, which is down in Menengon, where I was born and raised. Liberation Day, it means a lot to me because of you know, how it brings back memories of the Chamorros who had sacrificed a lot of their lives, you know, to save each other, you know. Like, unfortunately, it happened to them, and I hope it doesn't happen anymore like that. So, 1979, you know, brings back a lot of memories with this carabao that's here in our village. 1979, that carabao was on the float, and I was on the float with that carabao. My sister Mary, Talai, she was the queen back then for Big Roof. Since 1979, I really, you know, Liberation Day really meant a lot to me. Oh, I would love to celebrate Liberation Day the way we always did, with you know, all the people picking up canopies alongside, you know, Marine Drive, waiting for the next day to, you know, really go out with the bang. They're waiting for that. My name is Bill Ogunkinga. I'm the proud mayor of the village of Zonia. I'd like to wish everyone happy 77th Liberation Day. May God bless you all, and please be safe.
My name is Mayor Jesse Gogui. I'm the mayor of Talampaga Ordit. And our population here in Talampaga Ordit is roughly 6,800 people. You know, being a mayor of any village, I'm sure most mayors will tell you the day is never typical. And my routine is that once I leave the house, you know, I try to make my way around the village to just see what's going on. There are times where, you know, things are approved by Guam agencies, new construction, et cetera, that we don't see. And so it gives me an opportunity to see if activities have been approved and where they're at and the progress of those new construction or those new projects that were approved by, say, Public Works or Guam EPA, et cetera. Because what we try to focus here in the village are really infrastructure projects. Following up on road repairs, following up on water leaks, following up on streetlight repairs. One of the biggest projects we're working on now, or large projects we're working on now, is to try to build a multi-purpose center in the village. The other thing is that we finally closed the Ordit dump. I mean, finally closed the Ordit dump. And we're making headway in healing the environment. And it was because of the people of this village, the closure of the dump was forced to occur. Liberation Day meant a lot of things to me, and I guess it's evolved into many different things at my age. You know, I remember in the 60s and the 70s, where it's just going out and having fun. You know, the carnival was really the only game in town. as I've gotten older, you know, then, you know, the focus of enjoyment for me personally has gone from, you know, the carnival over to the parade. I've always enjoyed the parade. I enjoyed the parade when I was a kid. I remember back in the day when I was young, I marched in the parade. You know, we did village floats too. Just the camaraderie that was involved, that surrounded the construction of these floats was just heartwarming. It was a matter of village pride, you know? And everybody was just willing to go out and say, oh yeah, here's my contribution to liberation. But at the end of the day, at the end of all of the festivities, I think for me personally, what we got out of it is just spending a moment to recall, you know, the sacrifices that were made by our parents, you know, and our grandparents, and for some people, their great-grandparents. It's been frustrating. The year has been frustrating in that we haven't been able to celebrate liberation. But I know, given the resilience of our people and how we stay close to one another, all of you will find a way to celebrate. My name is Mayor Jesse Gogui. I'm from the village of Orichalampago. I want to wish all of you Happy Liberation Day. Good luck to you. Biba Liberation, Biba Salampago Orde, and Biba Guam.
My name is Jesse Allig, and the mayor of PD, and our population is 1,454. So every day is different. Everyone comes in bright and early, and we leave well into the day, late into the day. Typically, residents need assistance with forms, different types of forms that we might have for the different agencies. But of course, we do our regular village maintenance work on a daily basis. So I think the two best places to visit are our historical sites. The first historical site is the Atantano Shrine, and that shrine was erected since the Spanish times, and it was definitely put up by a Spanish governor, and it really was to commemorate the PD Agate Road. And then there's also a devotion to the Blessed Mother, which is also the patron saint of the village, and so it's kind of dual in purpose. And of course, the Japanese guns. So those guns were put by the Japanese during the war. They were never fired, but certainly a good historical site. The best part about it is it's part of the National Registry. I am proud to be the mayor of PD. I'm proud to be a resident of PD because the people of our village are not only friendly, but they truly are the type of people you want to meet and be neighbors with, because everyone helps each other out. Everyone is concerned about each other's welfare. So I'm proud to be from PD because the people make us shine. So since I've been mayor, we have had a float every year. But I do have to say that every float is a favorite float because it's so much work to do. The best part is when everyone gets together to fabricate it and to design it. What I really want to say about liberation is more about commemoration. In commemorating our liberation, we remember the valor, we remember the sacrifices of our manamko, our manaina, the people that did not make it through the liberation, and the people that are still around today. Their work and their sacrifices, I think, make us who we are and allow us to celebrate liberation. I dream that one day PT will really be a multi-generational community. Our community is growing, and so I would like to see PT become that village that houses all the facilities that are necessary for our people to truly live, work, and play. My name is Mayor Jesse Alec from the beautiful village of PT, and I want to wish you and your family a very happy 77th Liberation Day.
My name is Anthony Polino Charglove Jr., the mayor of Inalahan. We have approximately 2,450 residents living here. A typical day would be me reporting into the office right around 4:30, preparing breakfast for the maintenance staff, and then right before 7 o'clock, the guys head out into the field and try to accomplish the task for the day. And then, of course, right around 10:30 or so, I would stop my administrative duties, go back into the kitchen, prepare lunch for these maintenance folks, and they would come back, have their lunches again. We go through a mini brief. They go out and try to finish the task, whatever is remaining for the rest of the day. I am a proud resident of Inalahan simply because my upbringing was all about practicing our cultures and traditions. We have a very big manamko group that still is prevalent here. And throughout the years, learning to give that respect and staying humble throughout the whole time, I believe is why I love being here. And it's reminded of me each and every day, whether it be at the little mom and pop store, going to the church, or just at any of the scenic spots around the village areas. The boat ramp down by Bear Rock area is a nice scenic spot. The Inalahan pools, Gef Pago, the Chief Godow statue, and also the area they call Surfside, which is in the proper village proper of Inalahan. As a child, celebrating Liberation Day would mean my brothers and sisters, my parents loading up the car with a cooler of drinks, some sandwiches, some katumpika, rice and all, and taking that drive all the way down to the village of Agatnya, finding a parking stall or a spot, and then us just watching the entire parade until it's over, and then we just make that trek back home. Celebrating liberation after the pandemic would be really a hundredfold. Liberation Day really reminds us all of our manumkos, our war survivors, those veterans that help liberate Guam. I know many folks are eager and excited to celebrate liberation, not just the liberation from the past, but being liberated from the coronavirus, which we're all struggling for at the moment. One of the things that we want to try to do here in the village is really start off a skill sets academy. And what that basically is allowing the opportunity for a lot of our underprivileged folks who are not able to go on and venture off into college, whether locally or off island, to go and make a living and an opportunity to become successful. My name is Anthony Polino Charglove Jr., the mayor of Inalahan. The people of Inalahan and I would like to express a happy 77th Liberation Day to everyone. Stay safe.
I'm Louise Cruz Rivera, mayor of Tumuning, Tumon, and Harmon. And we have a population here of over 20,000 people. I am so proud to be from this community because we may not be the capital, but we surely are the heart of the island. You know, we have a very diverse cultural presence here in our community. We do have the historical landmarks. You know, here in Tumuning, Tumon, we have Gun Beach, Governor Joseph Flores Beach Park, also known as Ipao, Two Lovers Point, Punta Dos Amantes. It's always so busy around Tumuning. Liberation is very special to me. It's very important, you know, that we teach this and pass this on to future generations to let them be aware. we honor our Manumco, our survivors, and our heroes. And that's it's always been a great big party. It's like the fiesta of the whole island. With Liberation Day, it's for everyone. We call out everyone to come and enjoy. Just being able to see all the wonderful marching units and floats, the campouts, overnight partying. You see different families all gathered up in their tents and in their signs that display just supporting those who have to participate in the parade. It's always so wonderful, and I miss that. With everything that's going on through this pandemic, we continue to go out into the community, passing out food and homework and just trying to find ways to help our residents cope. And we're right now working together with our military command, our sister command from Anderson Air Force Base, the communication squadron, with the Army Hub Node, with different church groups, cultural dance groups, our sports groups. They're all coming together. And it's so wonderful how everybody is uniting together during this pandemic to work on helping others. And so now I'm sure with the closeness and the bond that we have created throughout this pandemic, the celebration will be so tremendous. I'm Louise Cruz Rivera, mayor of Tumuning, Tuman, and Harmon. And I'd like to wish everyone a happy 77th Guam Liberation Day.
Half a day. I'm Mike Varias of Varias Windsurfing. A father and son owned and operated windsurf training and safety program here on our beautiful island of Guam. We teach basic safety and windsurf fundamentals to all ages of at least 3 feet tall. And to give viewers at home a better perspective of what we do here, here's a few of our lovely students, Kelly, Kim, and Roz.
The mission of Varias Windsurfing is to encourage a healthy and active lifestyle while sharing the Hafide spirit amongst diverse communities here in Guam.
We generally take lessons here at Turay in the village of Pagatnya Beachside, Route 1, right off of Marine Corps Drive. Follow us on Instagram at Varias Windsurfing to book your lesson today.
A big shout out to Season Sidewalks in the Micronesia Mall and Turay Cafe for supporting us. But more importantly, we'd like to express our most sincere gratitude for all those who made the sacrifices for us to be here today.
On behalf of our fellow surf community, Varias Windsurfing, and all of our friends and family, we'd like to wish all of the Guamanians around the world a
happy 77th Guam Liberation Day!
My name is Johnny Ogun Kineta, the mayor of Humatic. Our population in our village is about maybe 1,200. Liberation Day means a lot to me. It's because this is the time where Guam got liberated, American came in, and this is how we are right now. We're living in a good life. We look at it this way, a lot of Chamorros suffered, died, you know. So celebrating this is very good for the people of Guam. What we do for liberation is we always go down to Hagatnya so we can barbecue and get together with all the Guam people. That's how we always do it every year. And people love that because you can see it, rain or shine, they're still out there trying to enjoy themselves. And I've seen it, I watch it in TV, rains hard. Maybe that's a blessing, you know what I mean? What makes me proud to be from Humatic is the people, the village, the hospitality. Those are the things that are very, very, the people's heart are very good in, with hospitality and stuff like that. The typical day in my office is mostly helping the people, Humatic, cleaning all the village, make sure that the village is staying clean. You have Sedebe Lookout, you have Celebe Lookout, you have the view, the mountain view, then you have the historical sites, and our bay, Humatic Bay. Those are the sites that is beautiful down here. What I like
like?
For the future of Humatic, we have to get over this pandemic first. Once the pandemic is over, you have a school up here that I want to fix, repair, and maybe move the mayor's office up there, community center. So that way, the kids have something to do every day after they're done with the recreational stuff. There's things for them to do after that. You know, they need recreation for them to keep busy. That's what I want. I want more things for the kids. I want Liberation to come back again so that the people can enjoy themselves like the way we used to. I want to go out with a blast. Because everybody wants to party. And it's hard because of the pandemic, and there's only a certain amount of people that are allowed to party. So, you know, everybody would want to come out and enjoy themselves. Barbecue like we used to. That's what I want to do. Go back out there with the people of Guam, you mad at? Build a float and enjoy like we used to before. My name is Johnny Ogunkinata, the mayor of Humatic. Happy Liberation 77th Day to the people of Humatic and the people of Guam, and God bless you.
Hafidi, buenas. My name is Mayor Kevin Suswico from the village of Agat. Our population in our village is about maybe 5,000, roughly 5,000 to 6,000. We typically drive around the municipality to go and see what it is that we can improve or what maybe needs to be done. It's really just a lot of hands-on every day. And, you know, again, we enjoy what we do. Liberation Day, it's a day of celebration. It's a day of remembering, but most of all, of celebrating, of course, of our past, of where we've come from. Being here on our island, we have many of our brothers and sisters that have fought to give us that freedom. It's a chance for us to remember what we went through, what our ancestors and our parents and our forefathers went through. The only part for the liberation that we also remember and we actually still commemorate is the Fena massacre, and which actually takes place at our newly built Haggard Memorial. And we invite a few of our survivors to come out and maybe lay a wreath or light a candle to remember the atrocities of the war. After the pandemic, I hope that we get back to our old custom parades and back down to Marine Corps Drive so that we can showcase our floats and our villages, you know, and what we have through the float. The past year was we actually built our little trailer floats, and we've actually gone around the municipality and we've celebrated in our own way, you know, throwing out candy to the kids on the side of the roads and, you know, kind of following all the proper protocol. I've lived in Agat all my life, and it's my home. It's a real joy and for me to actually be here in the place that I love. It's nice to pull over to the side of the even Route 2 as the sunsets are going down. So, you know, we take pride in our beautiful sunsets and being able to enjoy that right off of Route 2. You know, we see a lot of folks that come out and utilize the same road for barbecues and things right on the beach. So we invite everybody to come down and, you know, visit Agat and see what's going on. My name is Mayor Kevin Suswico from the village of Agat. And we wish everyone a happy 77th Liberation Day.
My name is Rudy Agampako, the mayor of Mong Mong Toto Maiti. I have a population of 6,825 residents. MTM didn't have that much people living in this community. It was more like an agriculture area. So people from Hagatnya will come over and do their farming. And then later on, when the Marines were here, they felt safe, and it also created jobs for the local people. We do have a memorial site. It's the 5th Field Service Depot. It was a Marine depot. It was there since 1944 to 1950. Liberation 2019, which was during my first term as a mayor, this was the first time in many years that MTM participated in a parade. Our float was very floral. We had different kinds of flowers, and we had different guys weaving, and we had guys that were good in decorating with flowers. When I was young, we would go down with my my parents and go to our relatives' campsite and watch the parade from there, you know, and just enjoy the day. I look forward in having our war survivors around us during a special time of the year and honoring them in this memorial. My name is Rudy Agumpaco, the mayor of Mong Mong Toto Mighty. I'd like to wish everyone a happy 77th Liberation Day.
Hi, I'm Wayne Wixon. I'm the president of the Guam Hogs for 2021. The Guam Hogs are a nonprofit organization that was formed in 1993. Our primary focus is to help Guam's children that are going off island for medical attention. We have four children that we're going to be helping this month, and we donate $1,250 per family to help these kids. We also help veterans organizations. That's not our mission statement, but every year we organize a Veterans Day ride, and we lead the Memorial Day ride. At Veterans Day, we raise money and donate it to various veterans organizations. Changes from year to year, but that's primarily what we do. The Guam Hogs would like to wish a very happy shout out to our veterans for the 77th Liberation Day.
My name is Alan Agocta, the municipal mayor here in Mindanao. Population of the village is roughly about 16,000 some people. To put a day in the office is very rewarding. every day is a challenge, but I go out there in the morning, check the main roads. Is there a complaint next to a bus stop, or is there something obstructing the road? Any concerns, water leaks for that matter, we try to address all of them accordingly. Right out here to the in the front of us, here in the office, it's the Father Duenas Memorial Sites, which commemorates the people from Mindanao and also those that have traversed all the way up to the Menengon Memorial. Being liberated, oh, means a great deal, you know. It commemorates all those who paid the ultimate sacrifice too as well. It's a day to reflect and be appreciative and remember those that we have lost. Mindanao being too as well, as we celebrate the second week of September as our Doni Festival, and the end of the month of September as our patron saint, Santa Teresita. So, you know, what more to also showcase our pepper. I would honestly say that putting a float together was a lot of work. It takes a lot of work and dedication. We pulled off one in 2 years ago with the Doni, I mean, you know, the chili pepper. That was one of my all-time favorites. So we had a huge pepper in the front of the float, and well, you know, I'm proud of the community and all the volunteers that made that happen, and of course the staff, because I mean, that pepper's really stood out there. Well, it'll be nice to get back into that mode again, in getting together with the family, getting together with the volunteers, and of course, looking forward to building another float. Buenas and off a day. My name is Alan Agocta. I'm the mayor of the District of Mindanao. I'd like to wish everybody a happy 77th Liberation Day. Biba Guam, Biba Mindanao.
My name is Ernest Chargo, and I'm the mayor of Mariso. Our village has approximately 1,800 residents. Liberation is just being liberated from when the anxieties and the atrocities were being inflicted upon our people by our captors, the Japanese. You know, our people were elated and very jubilant when they found out that the Americans were here, because they endured so much atrocities and fear. When I was younger, my dad was the mayor. Back then, his title was commissioner. Every year, the people would gather there to commemorate and perpetuate the atrocities and the massacres of the Tintan Far. The Japanese on July 15 and 16, okay? July 15, they gathered 30 of the most influential members of Mariso. under the pretense that they were going to be let to be protected from the bombings. They were taken to a name place, Tinta, told to go into the cave. When they got in there, they started throwing hand grenades in. And then after the barrage, they went in there and started probing at bodies and with their bayonets, and those that moaned, they were killed. Fortunately, 14 of our people were able to hide behind the dead bodies. It started to rain, so the Japanese fled for cover and allowed the other 14 to run away. And then the following day, they heard it. They gathered 30 of the strongest, toughest men of our village, and were taken to a name place called Faja, right above the cemetery. Okay, they told them to go down to a ravine. Once they got down there, they started submachine gunning them. So none of them survived. But several days later, when they found out those 14 people spread the word that these massacres happened, you know, Jose Faptonku, with the help of other residents and other men, were able to rebel against the Japanese guarding the village, and they overcame them, and those that weren't killed fled the village. And that's how we were liberated even before liberation. Our village was liberated. We were the first village to be liberated. That's the history of when we do the commemoration and the ceremony. I bring a message. We're honoring almost 70 people that were massacred and those that died during the liberation period. You know, as much as people would like to congregate and socialize, we have to protect ourselves. And this is a very deadly virus. We must protect each other. And I know that people long to hug and kiss everyone and be very friendly, very cordial to each other. But we are in the midst of COVID-19, and we're not over it yet. I'm proud, very proud to be and honored to be a resident of this village. I've lived here almost my entire life. The people here are very closely knitted. So the warmth and hospitality during our fiestas and when we parties, we embrace and welcome everyone. And that is the hospitality, not only of Mauricio, but of the South. My name is Ernest Charla, and I'm the mayor of Mauricio. I'd like to wish everyone happy liberation, and most especially to the families of those that we celebrate every year or honor those that were massacred at the Tinta and Faja massacre sites. And unfortunately, we are not able to meet because of the restrictions and social gathering. However, we will be having mass and to perpetuate and commemorate the passing of these individuals that were killed during liberation.
Buenas and off day. My name is Frankie Salas. I am the mayor of the most beautiful village of Asan Mihina. We have a population of 2,200. Asan is a beautiful beach to visit and spend a relaxing day with the family. In the one in the Pacific Park is a favorite place for the people of Guam to frequently and enjoy, as well as Chirito Beach. And also the Pacific War Museum, which is located in Adelope, and the Asan Bay Overlook Memorial, located in Limoncillo. When I was young, I remember going to a carnival, which was located at the Chief Kapua, where it stands now. Every village was being involved, and it's a really nice carnival. We have fireworks, and it's a really nice event. Liberation Day is a special day for the island of Guam. For me, it's time of remembrance for those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. My hope is that we're able to go back to have the Liberation Day parade and carnival again. I really miss that. And I think that people miss it too. And we all continue to work together to keep our community safe and residents and the children's. And we and them alone. My name is Frankie Salas, the mayor of the most beautiful village of Asamina. And I want to wish you a very happy 77th Liberation Day. Viva Asamina, viva Guam.
Buenas and half a day. Guahusi Eva again Cruz, and I'm the project director at Inafa Malik Youth Heritage Program. Here at Inafa Malik Youth, we are connecting our roots to our future. Our program is designed to empower the indigenous youth of the Marianas to have a positive sense of place and self, to have positive relations with one another, and to have an understanding of the cultural values and the inheritance that makes Chamorros unique. On a day-to-day basis, we are posted up here at the Sagan Kuturan Chamorro Cultural Center, where youth engage in different cultural activities to expose them to that experience. Over here at House 5, they have their language lessons, they listen to stories from elders about the history, and they also learn how to weave. Over at House 3, we have some plant identification and almond identification with Mama Chai. They also have some gardens that they're tending to. And down at House 2, they work with their Sinapaget to learn different recipes that are a part of the basic Chamorro cuisine. They also learn about our seafaring ancestry, other different ancient art forms that have existed. They dance, they chant, they sling. They even have gotten the opportunity to ride on a canoe, on a traditional style canoe. The experience that we're curating is about understanding what life was like for Chamorros and how our values were formed, and then how it applies to us in the modern day and how we can carry them on. On behalf of Inafa Malik Youth Heritage Program, I'd like to wish all of our fellow Chamorros, our Guamanians who are here and abroad, and all of our community a happy 77th Guam Liberation.
Senor.